Our coverage of Computex 2025 from Taipei, Taiwan is brought to you by Trix, Gigabyte, Thermaltake, G-Skill, and Cooler Master.
Hey guys, I'm at MSI now. I thought I'd wander over to their booth, and it's really crowded, so I chose a select few products to show you guys. We're going to start off with some video cards. All right, let's start off with the RTX 5060 8GB right here. We have not spoken very highly of this card, but, you know, since I haven't gotten any of them, and I don't have a driver to test them, I might as well take a look. This is the Ventus 2X OC, which is typically one of the more reasonably entry-level price options from MSI. Will this cost $300? I'm not sure. I don't have high hopes. We also have the Shadow 2X OC right here. Again, a pretty simple design, two-slot card. This one does come with a backplate on the back. Bit of a brushed metal finish on there, which doesn't look too bad. Some blow-through cooling down on this side. So this one just has a little bit of a different design aesthetic, though it still maintains the Torx 5.0 fans, zero frozer, zero fan mode. Just a slightly different finish than the silver version right here. Finally, we have the standard RTX 5060 gaming OC right here. They have locked these down tight, like you can barely touch them or move them or anything. But again, backplate on the back, dual fan cooling solution. This one uses a twin Frozer 10 thermal design and the Storm Force fans, which have the ring around the outside to help maintain stability. So this one is going to be a little bit more expensive than the two others that I just showed you, but we are still really up in the air in terms of what these are actually going to cost, just as we're still really up in the air in terms of the performance of these cards, because there have been no independent reviews thus far. Those will start trickling out, I imagine, this week and next week as people get the cards into their hands now that there's a driver available. But for those of us who are here at Computex, there's no way I can test this card right now, so I'm gonna have to wait and do something next week. Look, they're doing another Expert. I already took a look at this Expert card right here, the RTX 4080 Super Expert. This was one of the only actual unique designs for the 40 series that came out. That was completely brand new when they did the 4080 Super. I tested this card and unfortunately the performance was still a little bit shy of what the Founders Edition was getting. So it was a tough one to recommend. That said, there were a lot of people who really liked the design and still bought it. Or if you're able to find the 4080 Super Expert for a little bit of a discounted price, some people picked it up that way too. But now we have a new version, the RTX 5080 Expert OC right here. They have slightly updated the design. I'm not sure if you can tell, but it's more of a gold, maybe a soft blush gold. Here we have a solid black backplate, which is definitely a change from the original design. But we're still maintaining a lot of the similar blow-through fan area right here, just a distinct look. And they did say they're going to upgrade the cooling with a vapor chamber core pipe, optimized fin design, push-pull airflow is of course still being maintained. So look for this version of the RTX 5080 Expert OC to launch in Q3. And I'll be very curious to see if MSI was able to update the cooler on this enough to make it more competitive with the Founders Edition. And then of course, if it was available near MSRP, that would be great too. Over on this wall, we have some concept designs. MSI is working on some new designs to improve the cooling for their GPUs. So we have a radial sintered structure vapor chamber. You can see the standard vapor chamber over here on the left. Radial sintered structure vapor chamber right there. As you can see from this chart, the red is the heat and the arrows are the heat going away. So that obviously makes it better. More realistically, they're talking about using sintered core pipes, which are improved heat pipes versus standard heat pipes. And they have a little blowout design here so you can see the copper powder on the outside, the liquid flow, and then a coarser copper powder on the inside for the vapor chamber. MSI is toying with the idea of bringing back some of their iconic designs. You guys remember the Twin Frozer series of GPUs from MSI? I do. You gotta go back like 10 years or so, but these were like some really solid cards, and the Twin Frozers were always excellent, excellent cooled. The Twin Frozers were always like pretty top tier in terms of the cooling they were able to output. And for this potential new design, because this is still a concept product, MSI is considering bringing this back, but they're looking for feedback. If you guys are big fans of the Twin Frozer design, or just liking this sort of industrial get the job done look of this one, or maybe it looks like an owl to you, this could be eyes. But let us know in the comment section if you'd be excited for MSI to bring back the Twin Frozer series. Of course, they want to improve the cooling as well, though. So the actual fin stack right here, this is the old version using aluminum fins. Now we have copper aluminum composite fins, as well as a no solder hole design. So that is the cooler that is attached to this concept RTX 5060 Ti 16GB Twin Frozer right there. Here is the Cyclone, which was always a unique GPU cooling design in my experience in the past, because it uses copper orb style cooler, which just has a very interesting look. This one's on. I'm gonna try to try to pick it up without breaking it or anything like that. But as you can see, they're going with lots of copper here again, and I appreciate the use of that because copper works better as a heat sink and for heat dissipation versus aluminum. It is more expensive though and heavier. This one also has this crazy, apparently copper backplate as well. But perhaps most noticeable is going to be the fact that they added an LCD screen to the center of the fan, which is currently displaying some lucky animations, which looks pretty cool. That's an RTX 5070 12 gig, but again, concept design here, so MSI is wondering if anyone is interested in a unique design like this that hails back to MSI's storied past. And here we have the new version of the Supreme Titanium Edition. It says titanium, but it looks like it has a gold finish to me. This is an RTX 5090, of course, because if you can't tell, this is a premium high-end product. Can I pick this up?
No,
is that? Is that? Oh my God, that's pretty heavy. So I gotta do the side-by-side head comparison here because it makes a good thumbnail at least. This is reminding me of the new Asus one that they came out with that has 700 grams of gold and costs $4,000, whatever that costs. This one, they're at least using titanium. Titanium is more lightweight and is also very good at heat dissipation. It's got a really unique finish along the top here though. I don't know what to call this. I feel like this is a painting technique that I should be familiar with, but I'm not. Little blingy accents along the edge as well. I'm not sure how much titanium they're gonna be using in this card, but they are using the lightweight yet durable titanium for corrosion resistance and a sleek high-tech look. Of course, then you cover it with gold and people think it's gold, I guess. All right, that was a look at the MSI GPUs. They have lots of other stuff here, like the new Claw 8, which is actually AMD powered this time around. But I am out of time because I have so many meetings today. So that's gonna wrap it up for this one. Thank you guys so much for watching, and a huge thank you to my sponsors for Computex 2025, G-Skill, Cooler Master, Gigabyte, Trix, and Thermaltake. I got more videos coming at you real soon, so stay tuned, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.